There are 44 mutual fund companies in India, and there are more than 2,500 mutual fund schemes. And in case you are looking to select few schemes to help your customer meet their financial goals or to select a mutual fund house to start your mutual fund business, then you are in the right place. Today, I'm going to help you in understanding what things you should consider while selecting a mutual fund company or a scheme to suggest to your customers. Hello everyone, I'm Shobhit. I'm a FinBiz growth expert on a mission to help you in diversifying your business or start a mutual fund distribution business. I have created a system through which you will be able to start your mutual fund distribution business in 21 days. In case you have not subscribed to my channel, please do subscribe so that you can get notification whenever I put out any new content for your use. So coming back to the subject, I know it has been very confusing in case you are starting a mutual fund distribution business or you are in distribution business for a longer period of time to make a judgment which scheme, which fund house to work with, which fund house to not work with. Especially after the recategorization of all the mutual fund schemes done by SEBI in October 2017. In October 2017, all the schemes which are available in the market, they has been recategorized according to SEBI, according to their investment objective and the investment universe. So what I mean by that? I mean that suppose aap ek large cap fund mein invest kar rahe hain, SEBI ने रूल सेट कर दिया है कि आपको सिर्फ लार्ज कैप स्टॉक्स में ही 80% ऑफ द मनी इन्वेस्ट करना है. नाउ लार्ज कैप, मिड कैप और स्मॉल कैप स्टॉक्स की भी डेफिनेशन SEBI ने सेट कर दी है. द डेफिनेशन इज टॉप 100 स्टॉक्स अकॉर्डिंग टू द मार्केट कैपिटलाइजेशन वुड बी ट्रीटेड एज ए लार्ज कैप स्टॉक्स. नेक्स्ट 150 वुड बी मिड कैप स्टॉक्स और उसके बाद जो भी अवेलेबल है वो सारे स्मॉल कैप स्टॉक्स हैं. सो इन केस यू आर लुकिंग टू इन्वेस्ट इन ए लार्ज कैप फंड, देन योर फंड मैनेजर इज गोइंग टू पुट 80% ऑफ दैट मनी इन द टॉप 100 स्टॉक्स अकॉर्डिंग टू मार्केट कैपिटलाइजेशन. सो देयर हैज बीन लॉट ऑफ स्टैंडर्डाइजेशन ऑफ द यूनिवर्स इन विच द स्केल ऑफ द म्यूचुअल फंड कंपनीज आर गोइंग टू इन्वेस्ट और इन्वेस्टमेंट ऑब्जेक्टिव के भी हिसाब से ऑल द फंड्स हैज बीन रीअलाइन्ड. सो इन इक्विटी यू विल हैव 10 काइंड्स ऑफ म्यूचुअल फंड स्कीम्स, लार्ज मिड मिड कैप, स्मॉल कैप, मल्टी कैप. सो एवरी फंड हाउस विल हैव ओनली वन स्कीम इन लार्ज कैप, एवरी फंड हाउस विल हैव ओनली वन स्कीम इन मिड कैप स्पेस एंड सो ऑन एंड सो फोर्थ. सेम वे डेट कैटेगरी में टोटल 16 टाइप के स्कीम्स हो सकते हैं. In hybrid, there are 6 types of scheme. In solution oriented, like retirement or kids education, there can be 2 types of scheme and other schemes can be of 2 type. So these are the major categorization which SEBI has done. And now most of the mutual fund companies have schemes under these categories only. Iske bahar nahi ja sakte hain. So this is the way now the standardization has happened. And now you as a mutual fund distributor has to choose as how you should approach to select a scheme so that you can help your customer and more importantly make a balance between the business sense and customer sense. So humko in dono ka balance bana ke chalna hai, humko client ko bhi acha product dena hai, at the same time hume ye bhi khayal rakhna hai ki hamara revenue bhi ek large extent tak intact rahe. Agar hum kama hi nahi payenge to hum survive kaise karenge. So we need to make a balance of it. Now, how you should approach the selection of a scheme for your clients? How I look at it is there are 2 kinds of view in which you can look into it. The first thing is top-down view. Now, what I mean by that? Top-down view matlab aap pehle ek fund house select karte hain, fir dusre criteria like लोकल प्रेजेंस में उनका कैसा सपोर्ट है वो आप देखो, देन द स्कीम. सो इट विल बी अ मैक्रो व्यू लाइक यू आर लुकिंग फ्रॉम द टॉप. पहले आपको देखना है कि कौन सा फंड हाउस से आप ज्यादा कंफर्टेबल हैं. सो आप फंड हाउस सेलेक्ट करते हैं, फिर इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर यू टू लुक इनटू इट व्हाट काइंड ऑफ सपोर्ट यू आर गेटिंग फ्रॉम द respective company, because especially if you are not from metro location, अगर आप कोई रूरल लोकेशन से हैं, आप नॉन मेट्रो लोकेशन से हैं, जहाँ पे ज्यादा इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर अवेलेबल नहीं है, तो आपको ये बहुत ध्यान रखना है कि उनका लोकल सपोर्ट वहाँ मौजूद है कि नहीं है। स्कीम कितनी भी अच्छी हो, कितना भी अच्छा रिटर्न दे रहा हो, लेकिन जब क्लाइंट को सर्विस की जरूरत है, जब उसको पैसे की जरूरत है, जब उसको इन्वेस्ट करना है या निकालना है, अगर उसको ये सुविधा नहीं मिलती है, उसको किसी सर्विस में प्रॉब्लम आती है, इट इज ऑफ नो यूज। So you need to keep in mind that whenever you are selecting any scheme, especially if you are from non-metro location where infrastructure is not available to the large extent, then you need to keep this in mind what kind of local support you are having. If you are a new distributor, if you are going to jump into this bandwagon, you don't have much AUM, so you need to be very prudent in the cost structure also. And if the local support is available, it is going to help you. So just look into it whether the branch is available or not, or their staff is available or not, how cooperative their sales staff and operational staffs are, because it is very important. As I told you, my experience of more than a decade in the industry says that in case you are not able to do the operational thing on your own, or you are not going to get support from the local staff, it would be very difficult to exist or cooperate. So we need to keep this aspect in mind. Other important thing is, if the local presence is there, they can help you in the marketing also. आपका कोई marketing activity, आप कोई event करना चाहते हैं, आपको कोई support चाहिए, that also can be there from those staff or infrastructure whatever or branch which is available. So आपको ये बहुत ध्यान रखना है कि whenever we are looking to select any scheme, and if especially if you are new, I highly suggest that you take a first macro view, then come to micro view. आप पहले fund house देखो जो वहाँ पे present है, फिर आप उनका देखो क्या support system है. I especially recommend if you are someone who is looking for doing lot of offline transaction, which is paper transaction, then you should look into it whether mutual fund companies branch are available or not, or your RTAs are available or not. RTAs are like Carvey and CAMS who are going to help you in doing those transactions. So please keep this aspect in mind. It is going to help you in growing your business in an easy manner, and you will be able to scale up faster. Now the other way to look into it is just opposite of it. You are only looking at those schemes which are going to perform best. And then you are going to look at the other aspect like support system or the mutual fund company. Now my understanding is, if you are big enough, if you are there in the industry for a long period of time, or especially you are from metro location, then this makes sense, because now you don't require other outside support to manage your business. You know the nitty-gritties, you know everything, you can handle and you can approach everyone and anyone for any of your perspective. So just look at these two things. Either you can go from top down or you can go from bottom up. If you are new, if you are starting, my recommendation should be to you go from top down, so that you have the necessary infrastructure for yourself. आप बिजनेस को बढ़ा सकते हैं, आप कस्टमर को सपोर्ट कर सकते हैं, और वो भी आपको अपने बिजनेस को ग्रो करने में सपोर्ट कर पाएंगे. Now these are the two views. Now मैं क्या सोचता हूँ, what is my insight? Let me tell you how I want you to look into it while you are selecting a mutual fund company or a thing. The first and most important thing which I think which we need to be very aware of is the brand for which we are working with. जो ब्रांड है वो बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है, स्पेशली अगर आप एक नए खिलाड़ी हैं, आप एक नए म्यूचुअल फंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूटर हैं, तो आपको ये ध्यान रखना है कि आप अच्छे ब्रांड के नाम से शुरू करें, बिकॉज मोस्ट ऑफ द डिसीजंस विच योर कस्टमर इज गोइंग टू मेक और वी ऑल ऑफ अस मेक इज ऑन द इमोशनल फ्रंट. सो इमोशनली वी टेक द डिसीजन, देन वी विल पुट ऑल द लॉजिक टू satisfy it or make it a confirmation. So अगर ब्रांड अच्छा है तो आपको क्लाइंट को कन्विंस करने में ज्यादा टाइम नहीं लगेगा, आपको उसको पूरी उसका म्यूचुअल फंड कंपनी की हिस्ट्री बताने की जरूरत नहीं पड़ेगी. suppose you are argumenting for say SBI or HDFC or ICICI, they are well-known brands. So that's why you need to be very aware of that if you are starting or if you are working with a company who has a very good brand, your 50% of the work for mobilizing new business is well taken care of. And that's why we need to be very mindful of that brand should play, our brand will have a very big impact as how you are going to scale up your business. Now, I can give you multiple examples, but just take one example. If you look at last 3-5 years performance of HDFC mutual fund schemes, those especially in the equity category, they have not been that great. But still that company is growing at a faster pace. They are the second largest mutual fund company in India. Why? Because of the brand. Brand acha hoga to aapko business mobilization mein kaafi easy hoga. People are not looking only for the returns of the scheme. Especially in India where majority of the money is put into fixed deposits, people are more bothered about getting their money back. Just remember this quote, return of your money is more important than return on your money. Agar aapka capital hi wapas nahi aaya to aapke return se kya fayda hoga? Aur especially in India jahan pe majority of log fixed deposit se mutual fund mein move kar rahe hain, unko ye batana bahut zaruri hai ki unka paisa jahan ja raha hai wahan pe safe hai. And their brand plays a very important role. So I hope you are going to keep this aspect in mind that start with some good brand and gradually you build your own brand. How to set up your business, how to grow your business, how to take your business to the next level. For that, I have created a 90 minutes free masterclass in which I tell you how you can start your mutual fund business in 21 days. So in case you want to jump into this bandwagon, which industry, this industry has grown more than 5-fold in last 10 years, then do join my masterclass. I am going to leave the link for the masterclass in the description. I would love to see you there live. The other important thing which you need to keep in mind is what kind of revenue or commission you are getting from those schemes. Performance and everything is one thing, but since you are into this business, you need to be very mindful of what kind of commission the company is sharing with you. Remember, client interest is always first. But if you are not in there in this business, if you are not able to survive in this business, then how you are going to serve the client? So we need to make a very proper and adequate balance between the revenue and the performance of the scheme. Your performance should also be well taken care of. At the same time, you need to look into what kind of revenue company is sharing with you. You need to have a fine balance so that you can survive and flourish in this business. If you are not able to survive, then you will not be able to serve your client. Is not so? So just keep this aspect in mind. If you agree with me, just type agree in the comment box. So we need to have a very fine balance between what kind of support and what kind of revenue the company is sharing with you. Third is, as I told you, we need to be very clear on the operational efficiencies. Now, what I mean by that is, if you are starting new or if you are already an established player, then also I would highly recommend that start your business with the point of view that don't diversify too much to multiple mutual funds. And if you are diversifying into too much number of mutual fund companies, then you need to have multiple points of contact for any services. My recommendation would be that once you are starting, you need to keep in mind that the select those mutual fund schemes which are attached to one RTA, either Karvi or CAMS. So if you are new, you are establishing your business, I highly recommend that either you choose few companies who are having a relation with CAMS or Karvi, so that from one RTA you will be able to get all your work done, all the service, all your data mining, all your business information is will be easy for you to gather. So this will all will make sense in case you are already into the business. But if you are looking to get into the business, as I told you, do join my masterclass so that I can share insights with you. So just keep that, don't diversify or don't spread your business too thin into multiple mutual fund companies, because you will have now multiple points of contact, and it will unnecessarily create more vulnerability for you. Another important thing which you need to keep in mind is most of the mutual fund companies in India will give you your commissions, your brokerage based upon the volume of business which you are doing with them. So if you are able to get 2-3 mutual fund companies and able to allocate most of your business to them, then you will be getting higher commission based upon the volume of business which you are doing with them. Higher the volume you are going to do with one mutual fund company, they are going to upgrade to the next level. So we need to keep in mind that if we are able to start and able to accumulate some minimum threshold AUM with some companies, your commission will be upgraded to the next level. But if you keep on segregating your client's investment into multiple AMCs, then everywhere you will be in the lowest slab. So if आपको अपना कमीशन का अगर रेट बढ़ाना है तो आपको ये समझना पड़ेगा कि आप बहुत सारे म्यूचुअल फंड कंपनी के साथ आप काम ना करें, क्योंकि अगर बहुत सारे म्यूचुअल फंड कंपनी के साथ आप काम करोगे तो फिर हर जगह आप सबसे नीचे वाले स्लैब में रहोगे। सारी कंपनियां आपको कमीशन स्लैब के हिसाब से देती हैं। अगर आपने 1 करोड़ का धंधा उनके साथ किया तो आपका कमीशन रेट ये रहेगा, 2 करोड़ का किया तो कमीशन रेट ये रहेगा। अगर आप स्टार्ट कर रहे हो या आप ऑलरेडी एस्टैब्लिश प्लेयर हो तो आपको ये ध्यान में रखना है कि डोंट डाइवर्सिफाई और डोंट सेग्रीगेट योर इन्वेस्टमेंट ऑफ क्लाइंट्स इनटू टू मेनी म्यूचुअल फंड कंपनीज। सो इट इज गोइंग टू हेल्प यू। नाउ एंड लास्ट एंड मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग आई विल शेयर विथ यू इज डोंट रन और चेज टू मच ऑन द परफॉर्मेंस फ्रंट। एवरी म्यूचुअल फंड स्कीम सेज दैट द परफॉर्मेंस इज सब्जेक्ट टू मार्केट रिस्क। Today, any fund which is 5-star rated or having a CRISIL 1 rating doesn't mean that it is going to be there for the next 10 years also. Every scheme will keep on changing the returns and performance. What we need to look into it is that whether the mutual fund company first is will be able to survive for a longer period of time, they are serious player. Second, whether the fund management team is stable or not. If fund managers keep on going here and there, then it doesn't argue well. Third, whether the scheme is very strict in terms of the investment objective. Large cap fund mein 80% of the paisa hamesha large cap mein rehna hi chahiye. Agar aap scheme ka fund manager strict karta hai, then it is our job to take those schemes because the company and the fund manager is following what is the objective of the scheme. So, ये कुछ पॉइंट आपको ध्यान में रखने हैं। हमको रिटर्न को ही सिर्फ क्राइटेरिया नहीं लेना चाहिए, क्योंकि आप सिर्फ रिटर्न को क्राइटेरिया लेंगे देन आप क्लाइंट को भी यही प्रोपोगेट करेंगे, एंड दैट इज नॉट राइट थिंग। देर आर लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स विच वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड इन द वे वी कम्युनिकेट टू आवर क्लाइंट, एंड इफ यू चूज टू ज्वाइन आवर कम्युनिटी वी विल बी मोर देन हैप्पी टू शेयर विद यू दिस इनसाइट्स। So I hope you got some insight as how you need to pick up scheme, a mutual fund company, so that it is easy for you to grow and multiply your business. In case you like the content, do give us a thumbs up, do share your insights so that we will be able to get more such kind of contents to you. Thanks for watching. Today I am going to signing off. Until I am going to meet you next time. Thank you very much.